year marks the 10th year anniversary since Machu Picchu was created and founded by my sister Melanie. And it also marks the 400th year anniversary of the first historical evidence of Pisco production in Peru. The coincidence not only has to be celebrated, but really celebrated in a grand style, I think. The challenge was, think of Pisco in a new and different way. We wanted people to think completely outside the box. And in order to allow them to do that, we couldn't handcuff them and say, these are rules and these are guidelines. We hand-selected cities where the competition would take place, and that was Washington, D.C., New York, Boston, Chicago, Las Vegas, San Francisco, and L.A. The response that we got was exactly what we were dreaming of. The people who participated across the board, and I could name so many, just come from establishments that have a worldwide reputation for excellence, and that is really what we were most thrilled about, because these are the people in whose hands Pisco can come alive.
The thing that I love about La Diablada is that it's a beautifully floral spirit that really stands up well in cocktails.
I love it, the La Diablada, because I think the blend is so well done. It's a little bit floral, but still very earthy. It mixes really well, so for a cocktail bartender, it's a really fun product to work with.
We always say consumers can make a difference and you have a choice. And so really it was the consumers who made a choice and said, hey, we love this cocktail. This is the cocktail that happened to shine in this given market. So the best selling cocktail is the one who determined which cocktail master got to come down to Peru. The driving force in creating this itinerary for the trip is really to make sure that people get to experience the Peruvian culture and our hospitality. And obviously we are so very proud of our Pisco, but we're very proud of many other amazing Peruvian jewels, such as our gastronomy, such as the Pisco Valley and Machu Picchu. And we are actually gonna have a very tight schedule. In 7 days, everybody's coming down for a full week, and they are gonna land in the capital of Peru during the week of Mistura, which happens to be the largest gastronomic festival in all of South America. And they're going to be able to enjoy Mistura and discover all the gastronomic wonders and really experience Peruvian food in an elevated manner that hasn't yet come to the United States.
I'm very familiar with typical, you know, Peruvian cuisine, like the papas a la cocaína and the ceviches, because that's what I've been exposed to, but I'm excited to see what other ingredients and fun food they have over there.
This year, the UN dedicated and named 2013 the year of the quinoa, and our First Lady has been named ambassador to the world to promote quinoa, and we thought, now that we have the 10 best mixologists and bartenders of the US, why not give them a true challenge and say, hey, how can you incorporate quinoa into a La Diablada Pisco cocktail?
Well, I've only eaten quinoa when I'm being healthy, so it's a very good challenge. I was a little thrown off by it, honestly, but it's also be really fun because we have so many people from all over the country, and people always will bring something different, so I'm really interested to see what other people do with it. Of course, I'm still definitely pondering what I'm gonna do.
Quinoa is difficult because as a grain, it's not something that can easily be infused. It takes a lot of prep work. So I'm playing right now with, you know, malting it and making milks and seeing exactly what I can get from the quinoa. Now, I think for me, I thrive the best when I have restrictions. So I'm really excited to see what comes out of it.
It's nice to actually be in a competition where I feel like we've actually stumped these bar chef masters, if you will. You know, we didn't really expect it, but you know, people are really talking about it and people are really researching it, and you know, to ignite that is a great conversation to be having right now. All the participants are going to get to tell the judges an inspiration as to what their cocktail and the name of the cocktail is, and it has to relate to the ancestral beginnings of Pisco and quinoa and the interplay between these two things and how ingrained they are and how inherent they are to our traditions and Peruvian cultures. The winning cocktail is going to be named the Pisco Quinoa Cocktail of the Year. We just want it to be a living, breathing experience, not just what's in the glass, but hopefully when they get to come back and be behind their bars, they're going to be able to talk, you know, with anybody sitting at the bar about their experience and new things that they've discovered.
I'm hoping when I get back from my trip to Peru, I'll have great answers for people that are interested in pisco and want more in-depth knowledge about it. I'm also really interested in how Peruvians drink pisco and how they enjoy it, so maybe it will give us more ideas for cocktails we can make at Rain's Law Room.
We, you know, are open to having inspirations be street vendors, you know, on the corner of streets, something like a food or a smell, anything that can, as I said, spark creativity. But they're going to be able to communicate that. So when people drink their cocktail, they will know exactly, you know, what was the little seed that from where it grew.
One of the reasons that I'm really excited to go to Peru is to explore the culture and the life that exists in Lima, Peru.
I'm very excited. I couldn't be more honored to go to Peru, especially with this select group of people.
So I'd like to thank Melanie Asher and Lizzie Asher of Machu Pisco and La Diablada Pisco.
Can't wait to see you guys in Peru.
Buena suerte a todos, chicos, y que disfruten mucho. Los veo cuando están de regreso. Suerte. Chao.